All right, everyone, it's time for us to put on our scholar caps tonight. Actually, just kidding. No scholar would make this video. All right, everyone, my name is Brinley. Welcome back to my channel, and today we'll be talking about the book Daughters of Eve by Lois Duncan. Where to start with this book? Okay, so I read this book for a class, and in said class, we were not allowed to say, oh, obviously, because it's not scholarly, if we didn't like this book or we did like it. It was kind of the shtick of the class. We had to analyze each book from the perspective of a different type of literary criticism. Okay, great. I hated this book. I think this is one of the worst books I've ever read. In fact, I think it might be even one of the worst books of all time. And I hope by the end of the video, you will feel the same. Today, we're gonna be talking about a little bit about what the book is about in general, a bit about the history of the time when it came out and it was written, because I think that's especially relevant to the content of the book. You'll see why in a second. And kind of three main points I've outlined why this book is trash, which could all be summarized in that the book itself is anti-feminist. The Daughters of Eve by Lois Duncan is considered to be a horror or suspenseful book. So I've summarized the plot in one sentence. The book tells the story of a group of girls in small town America who are quote unquote radicalized by a feminist to take revenge against the men in their lives. All right, so The Daughters of Eve was published during an especially tumultuous time in the United States, especially with the question and conversation of gender equality. So it was published in 1979, and ever since 1923, when the Equal Rights Amendment was first introduced, it became the center of many debates about women, gender, and society. Even though this book is identified by critics as both feminist and anti-feminist, I believe The Daughters of Eve is inherently an anti-feminist book based on anti-feminist ideology of the 1970s. So, here's some examples. Or actually, my main points about how The Daughters of Eve is anti-feminist and perpetuates this anti-feminist rhetoric. For example, feminism is anti-family. Women who are scorned become feminists. Women belong in the home. And last but certainly not least, feminists hate men. All right, so we're gonna talk a little bit about the reception of The Daughters of Eve and the history at the time. I will try to make this as easy to understand for people who may not know about the history of gender equality or movements for gender equality in the United States as possible. To fully understand Lois Duncan's book, The Daughters of Eve, we must understand second wave feminism. So, I have a definition of feminism right here. I have a couple. So I'm going to read them off just so I don't get them wrong, okay? Feminism is the social and political movement for women's equality and the belief that women and men are inherently of equal worth, while bell hooks defines feminism as the struggle to end sexist oppression. At the time when The Daughters of Eve was originally published, it is a time that historians in the field of women and gender studies have since labeled as second wave feminism. They have labeled the second wave as taking place during the 1960s and the 1970s. All right, so the second wave was characterized by the fight for reproductive justice, access to prenatal care and breastfeeding support, expanded educational and occupational opportunities for women, while also access to other political rights, safety from violence and elimination of cultural sexism, and also the lower social status of women. I would characterize second wave feminism as not intersectional at all. During this time, the Equal Rights Amendment was up for ratification. People on both sides, whether they were for the amendment or against it, were quite vocal in the news. This time gave rise to many anti-feminist leaders and anti-feminist rhetoric, such as the beliefs perpetuated by Phyllis Schlafly. All right, I literally never want to say this, but let's talk about Phyllis Schlafly. Please bear with me, I might get very angry. So, the anti-feminist movement I've mentioned before is characterized by a certain set of beliefs they claim are in, quote, juxtaposition with feminist beliefs, but are mostly based on not true stereotypes. Anti-feminism in the 1970s is characterized by the misguided and incorrect belief that feminists hate men, that feminists are anti-family, and that women belong in the home. Don't believe me? Let's hear from Schlafly herself. Here we go. And I quote, "The women's libbers are radicals who are waging a total assault on the family, on marriage, and on children." As mentioned in this quote, women are categorized by the anti-feminist movement as over-emotional radicals who hate men and their families. So I have another quote by Phyllis Schlafly that actually is about Miss Magazine, and Miss Magazine is a magazine from that time period that was a radical feminist magazine. So here's the quote. "The principal purpose of Mrs. Shrill Tirade is to sow seeds of discontent among happy married women so that all women can be unhappy in some new sisterhood of frustrated togetherness." This perjurated definition of, quote, sisterhood is the same definition of sisterhood we see in Lois Duncan's The Daughters of Eve. All right, so this is a spoiler alert. Yes, this book came out in the 70s and was republished in 2011, but I'm still gonna give one. I will put a timestamp in the description of where you can skip to if you want to skip the spoilers and just go to my conclusion. But also, this book did come out in the 70s, so. Even though some critics have said this book balances a feminist and anti-feminist rhetoric, the ideology of the time proves that this book is anti-feminist. So I'm gonna start out by talking about chapter 8 of Duncan's book. In this chapter, the club members have a conversation about gender roles and future jobs. Irene, who is the radical feminist teacher from Chicago, proposes this question to the group. How many of your mothers hold jobs outside the home? In this conversation, Irene helps the girls in the club think about what's expected of them as women and how their mothers are being affected by sexist gender roles. So that sounds like a great question to get the juices flowing, to start a feminist or a conversation that might challenge some of the social norms of the time. Well, hold on. So later in the book, Anne, one of the characters, gets pregnant, and Irene encourages her to get an abortion. Irene outlines how having the baby will essentially ruin Anne's life. Pregnancy and motherhood are the ultimate weapons men can use to keep women helpless and in their place, in case you are going to be robbed of a wonderful future. In its way, that itself is a form of murder, isn't it? It's the murder of Anne Whitton, the artist. And that was on page 232. So on the surface, these statements really seem to align well with the feminist ideas about having careers instead of being homemakers, but it actually reinforces negative and oppositional beliefs about feminism. At the time, many people did not support the ERA or Equal Rights Amendment. Phyllis Schlafly, like I mentioned before, the anti-feminist activist, said this in an interview with the New York Times. Oh, and this interview was against the ERA. "The anti-family nature and the destructive potential of the unisex ERA." So she's essentially saying that the ERA will destroy families and will destroy, I guess, women's autonomy. I think that's what she means by saying it's unisex. Duncan plays completely into Schlafly's and other anti-feminist beliefs that feminism is against families. Well, this is not true. Feminism is simply the belief in gender equality. It's not saying that someone shouldn't be a homemaker. It's not saying that you can't have a career. It's saying that people, no matter their gender, should be treated equally, not only in the eyes of the law, but in the eyes of society. That's what feminism at its core is. All right, so yet another anti-feminist ideology from the 1970s is the belief that women belong in the home. While the book on the surface doesn't exactly seem to support this idea, it actually does. For example, when Irene reminisces on why she left her former partner Bob, he says this to her. "You'll stop working anyway when the babies start coming." That's on page 135. Irene didn't like this, as her dream was to be a principal. This scene seems to condemn the idea that women should stay home and be housewives. But however, this still plays into the anti-feminist ideas that women want to be housewives, and therefore feminism is taking that away from them. And Irene is presented as a conniving, radicalizing figure, rather than someone the reader should sympathize with. The ideology of the anti-feminist in the 1970s, one of their core tenets was that women belong in the home and that women just want to be wives and mothers, even if they don't think they do. To quote from Phyllis Schlafly again, "The women's libbers don't understand that most women want to be wife, mother, and homemaker, and are happy in that role." While the women in the Daughters of Eve are radicalized by their teacher Irene to become, quote, militant feminists, in the end, many of the women still fit into anti-feminist ideas about romance and belonging at home. For example, Fran, who is depicted as not caring about romance in the opinion of men, gets a love interest named Gordon. That happens on page 222. Again, Anne, who received a full ride art scholarship to a university in Boston, chooses to keep her baby and become a housewife instead of pursuing a career in art. And I will quote from the end of the book on page 265 now. Anne Witten Brewer is a housewife in Modesto, Michigan. She is the mother of two sons. Another way the Daughters of Eve perpetuates anti-feminist rhetoric of the 1970s is through the stereotype that feminists must hate men. The back cover of the Daughters of Eve, the 1981 edition, proposes this question. Were brothers, boyfriends, and fathers the enemy? Before the girls are radicalized by Irene, they believe that not all men are the issue. And I quote, "Not all men," Anne said, frowning. "Dave isn't like that, and neither is my father," Duncan 107. Later, after Peter wrongs Bambi, they were in a relationship, and Laura and Mr. Carncross seemingly discriminate against Fran, the club discusses problems with society. In this same chapter, Tammy, one of the female characters of the book, thinks about the girls' passion for getting revenge against the men that have wronged them. And I quote, "There was something about this face she had never seen before. The softness was gone from it. So was the warmth, cold and distant and outrage. What has happened to Kelly? What has happened to us all?" Duncan, 216. These selections imply that the girls in the club hate men in their lives, and they hate all of the men in their lives. Also, Irene, the teacher and the radicalizer of the characters, hates men as well. And I quote, "One man was like another. The hatred rose within her, thick and stifling. So many long years wasted." Duncan, 135. So the book ends with Kelly, one of the main characters, killing her abusive father with a skillet. Her father attempted to both force Kelly and her mother into traditional gender roles and abuse them both. Through Irene's teachings, Kelly gains the confidence to stand up to her father, and this eventually leads to her breaking down and killing him. This hatred of men is part of the misconceptions anti-feminists spread about feminism. In the New York Times, an article from 1982 discusses how the term feminism has perpetuated in culture, and I quote, "Not for me, but for the guy next door, that would mean I hate men." Duncan's work clearly interacted with the perjuration of the term feminism, as the women in the story are depicted as crazed radicals who take revenge way too far. Lois Duncan's The Daughters of Eve is just a horrible book. It's a narrative that is constructive, and it wants readers to be nervous and afraid of feminists rather than horrified by the acts of abuse and the marginalization of women by the patriarchy that take place in the novel. Considering textual evidence, The Daughters of Eve is more complicated than it first appears. It doesn't balance the ideologies portrayed within the novel. It's clear to see where anti-feminist beliefs align within the text and the main idea of the book. Since this book is identified as a horror book, it attempts to portray women enacting revenge on men and taking autonomy for themselves as something that is terrifying. Therefore, people should be afraid of feminists. All in all, The Daughters of Eve is an inherently anti-feminist work, based on the ideologies it condemns and supports surrounding the second wave of feminism and anti-feminism of the 1970s. Okay. So why do I think this book is one of the worst books of all time? I think it's one of the worst books of all time because folks, even still today, try to portray it as something that displays both sides of the issue. There isn't a both sides. Feminism is the belief that every gender should have equality. And The Daughters of Eve is an anti-feminist rhetoric book that's saying feminists hate men, feminists hate their families, or even people who have families, and that feminists are only women who have been wronged by men. Anyone can be a feminist. And the reason why I made a video about this is because I really think we should be talking about books in this context. Oftentimes in scholarship, people hesitate away from making judgment statements like this book is anti-feminist or this book is not good because it is anti-feminist. And I really think this should be a conversation we're having. So if anything I said today resonated with you or was curious, please comment down below. I really want to talk about this. Were you as horrified as me when some of these quotes were read out? Were you as horrified that it was essentially propaganda, or I believe it's propaganda for Phyllis Schlafly's personal beliefs? I'll be honest with you, I hated reading The Daughters of Eve, but the second I picked it up, I couldn't put it down because I got so angry at everything that was going on in the novel. At first I thought, this is pretty cool. A group of girls gonna take revenge on their oppressors. And you know, it may not be the best concept because I don't know if that's the best way to handle things, but I thought it was gonna be a fun read. And as soon as I figured out what was really going on in this book, I got really frustrated and I wanted to share this as a conversation that we can have. Because this book is still in circulation. As I mentioned, it was republished, I believe, in 2011. They changed some parts of it, but not enough. And so I just thought this was an important conversation that we should probably be having about this book. All right, thanks so much for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on the notification bell if you enjoyed this video and want to see others like it. Please let me know what you think. And also, I'm going to be putting my work cited in the description box. If you're interested in seeing more videos like this in the future, please let me know. And I'm trying to post every 2 weeks. So we'll see how that goes. Thanks so much for watching again.